by living every day near to God the Father and following in His way. For God alone can teach you the meaning of true love, and He can help you establish the life that you're dreaming of, in which you live together in happiness and peace, enjoying marriage blessings that day by day increase. For love that is immortal has its source in God above, and the love you give each other is founded upon His love. And though upon your wedding day it seems yours and yours alone, if you will but ask, God will take your love and blend it with His own. Let us pray. Oh God, our loving Heavenly Father, our hearts rejoice today for Robert and Lauren as they unite their hearts and lives in covenant to one another in marriage. We rejoice that they come seeking to make Christ the center of their relationship, and we pray for them as they journey forth together as partners in Christ and partners in marriage. May the joy that you intended for all who marry be their constant companion and give them even more reason to praise you in the future. Father, we ask this prayer with happiness in our hearts and gratitude in our souls. Amen. There's a legend, Lauren and Robert, that in biblical times there was a certain young king who married a princess from a neighboring country. Soon after their marriage, it became necessary for the young king to leave his young bride and lead his army into battle. One night before he left, the king was walking in the palace gardens. He stood beside the moon-drenched pool, tossing pebbles into the water and watching the circles form on the surface. How like a circle is my love for her, he thought. It too has no beginning or ending. And so the next day, the young king called in his goldsmith and directed him to make a gold circle to fit the queen's finger. And as he slipped the finished product upon her finger, he tenderly said to her, "This circle, which has no beginning or ending, is a pledge of my love for you, which is also eternal." And so down through the ages, the gold circle has sealed the vows of marriage and symbolized the purity and endlessness of true love. Robert, may I have the ring for your wife to be, please? Robert, it's a ceaseless reminder of this hour and of the vows that you have made this day before God and these witnesses present. I'm going to ask you to take this ring, please. And as you place it upon the hand of Lauren, I'm going to ask you to listen to these words of the pledge of your love to her. And at the end, please say, "I do." Do you promise, Robert, that this ring you're placing on Lauren's finger will serve as a symbolic reminder of your pledge to be faithful to her in marriage, to provide for her as best you can, to share with her all your worldly goods, and to love her in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit? Now, Lauren, may I have a ring for your husband? Lauren, as a ceaseless reminder of this hour and of the vows that you have made before God and these witnesses present, take this ring, please. And as you're placing it upon Robert's hand, please listen to these pledges, these words, and at the end, please say, "I do." Do you, Lauren Burke, promise that this ring you're placing on Robert's finger will serve as a symbolic reminder of your pledge to be faithful to him in marriage, to provide for him as best you can, to share with him all your worldly goods, and to love him in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit?
I'm gonna be
studied it together according to the principles of the Christian faith and the laws of the state of Virginia, and I, as an officer of the law, according to the state of Virginia, and as a minister of the gospel, with the power invested in me, I now declare you husband and wife. What therefore God has joined together, let no man put asunder.